Hi, I'm Gary Eckstein from organicweb.com.au and I'm a Mailchimp Pro partner. Please like this video, subscribe to my channel, leave a comment, I'd very much appreciate it. In the past, I've gone through how to add the first name automatically into an email. In other words, personalize your email. Mailchimp has a new email builder, so I thought I'd show how easy it is to personalize your content by adding the first name of the recipient into your emails. Let's go across to Mailchimp. I'm in Mailchimp, so to add the first name, in other words, hi, first name, dear, first name, and so on, I'm going to go to my campaigns. I start building my campaign. Now I've already started building this domain, so I'll click edit. Very importantly, make sure that you've selected your audience that you want to send to. That should be automatically selected if you only have one audience. If you have more, just make sure that you have your audience selected. In the content section, I'm going to click edit. Then, to add my first name is very simple. So for example, wherever there's a text block, I can just click, and wherever I want my greeting, so I'll just do space, let's type in here, hi, space, and then wherever I want my first name, I click merge tags, and I just click first name. So merge tags, first name, and maybe I want to put in a comma, and let's just make the U into a lowercase y. So, hi, first name, so that will automatically populate with the first name of your recipient. So it'll look at each email address in your audience and go, what is the associated first name, and insert that and go down. Okay, so hi, first name, so that's how simple it is. Now, if we want to test that that's actually working, that's simple, we click preview, then, just click the sort of toggle button on enable live merge tag info. And just bear with me, I'm just going to go on to the next person. So what you'll see here is hi Lee, comma, and so on. And I can try then the next person, hi Hannah. So that's what Hannah will see, Lee will see, etc., etc. So that's how easy it is. We just use that merge tag drop down and click on first name, it inserts it. Now just carrying on a little bit, a very common question is, what happens if we don't have the first name for some people? Well, let's go to our audience. What we can do in Mailchimp is we can set what's called a default merge tag. So we can set a default name or something that will appear should we not have the first name for a person. Because by default in Mailchimp, it'll leave the value empty. So if you're going dear first name comma, it's not going to make sense if you don't have the person's first name, because it'll just go dear space comma. Okay, so we can set a first name such as member, such as employee, customer, whatever. That's very simple. So in Mailchimp, to set the default merge tag info that will show should we not have the the recipient's first name, and you're using the first name merge tag, what we do is we view our contacts. We click settings, we click audience fields and merge tags. As we're looking at the screen on the left hand side, we can see there's the first name field. If we look to the right, we can set a default merge tag value, and that's where we would type something like customer, member, whatever makes sense, fitness guru, whatever. Always remember, however, that on this screen, we must click Save Changes. So now, when we don't have the first name for a person and we're using that first name merge tag value, we will see customer instead of the first name. That's how easy it is. Please like this video. I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au.